There's a lot that's not known, but we can at least draw some conclusions that if Iran wanted to develop a longer range, that's probably where they would go. They also could try to put together a two- or three-stage solid-fueled system based on the Sajil-2, the system that they recently have developed that can fly 2,200 kilometers with a 750-kilogram warhead. They could try to develop this technology into a two-stage system, and probably, you know, that might be a more militarily significant system for them, because solid-fueled missiles can be launched more rapidly and they launch more quickly. They're harder to preempt. You know, a liquid-fueled, they're on the launching pad. Fueled missile. In the liquid-fueled missile area, Iran has largely relied on engines originally from the Soviet Union and Russia, although whether they came directly from Russia or through China or through North Korea, it's not always clear. So in the liquid-fueled, more reliance on technology overseas. In solid-fueled, more indigenous capabilities. If Iran were to go beyond what they currently have and develop longer range, they probably would need some foreign assistance.
به عنوان نهمین کشور دارنده این فناوری از کشورهایی که دارای این علم هستند محسوب می‌شود.
Kilometer reach Scud A's and B's are from Soviet Union and via North Korea. The Scud C's, which North Korea calls the Nodong, and Iran fielded as the Shahab 3, these are foreign technologies.